Hey guys, this is Dooley. In this video, we are going to continue talking about the child process module in Node.js. Today we'll focus on the spawn function, which will allow us to simply create new processes by providing a command, some optional arguments that could be flags to this command or just arguments to that command. And optionally provide an options object which will sort of tell the child which directory it should be started in, what sort of variables or environment variables are available for it to start with, what sort of relationship it's going to have with its parents, whether the parents can send message to it or it can send message to its parents, and whether the streams, the STDIO, the standard IO stuff of the parent would be shared with the child and so on. Okay, so I have here pulled the child process object from the child process module, and I also have an object here I call progs, which essentially has as properties three commands that I'd like to play with in this video. Alright, so the simplest thing you can do with the spawn function is simply create a child process by simply providing a sample command. And the one we're going to play with for now is the list command. So let's go ahead and do that. So let's create a child. So what we're going to do, we're just going to call the spawn function. And we are going to provide the command that we want to run. Oops. Okay, so let's go ahead and run that. See what happens. Nothing. Well, that doesn't mean nothing is happening. What that means is something's happening, but we're not seeing it. And the reason why we're not seeing it, if you think about it for a little bit, when you start a node process, when you say node and then the file name, what you'll do, you will start a process. And once you start a process, your program will be running within that process, and your program will have access to the environment that process provides and resources within that environment. And some of these resources are the process standard R, the process standard N, the process standard error. When you print something and you say console.log, what's happening is you are taking some data and you are piping them through the process that standard out stream. So this child process, when it's printing something, it's also printing to that standard outstream, but its own, not the process that this parent process has access to. So the way you access that standard out is by getting that property on that child process. Okay, so the way you do that is you get that right here. So it's a property in that child process, and because it is a stream, we can listen for data events. So what you can do here is get that data. So data events, when they're fired, they will emit with that with the data object there. Okay, so what we can do, we can log this to the console. All right, so let's do some interpolation here. Data is going to be data. Okay, I don't want four here. What I want is a dollar. All right, so let's run this and see what we get. Now you can see that I get a copy of, not a copy, but a list of all the files that are in this current directory. And you can see, there are six files in here, and as we know here as well. All right, so what else can we do with this? All right, Right, so we can provide some additional arguments. So what we're essentially doing here is just this. Okay, we're listing all the files in this directory. All right, so if you know this command, you also know that you can provide the flag A. And what the flag A does, it will print all the hidden directories and files that are in this directory. Right, so the same way, you can provide this flag in here as well, in the array of arguments that you can provide here. So let's go ahead and do that. Okay, how is this going to behave? Let's run the program, and you can see you get the same thing here as well. So you get the hidden current directory and the hidden previous directory in the hierarchy in there as well. All right, so you can also, by providing some options, dictate where this child process runs. Okay, you can say, I want this child process to run in the previous directory, in the previous directory in the hierarchy. All right, so we can run that again. And as you can see here, we are getting outside of the directory we were working in. And essentially what you're doing is ls a and then in the previous directory. So you can see you're essentially getting the same thing here. All right, this is the same result. Okay, one other command we could play around here is the long command, which will give us the permission, the creator. Actually, I printed something else. Let's do that. Okay, so we get the permission for the user, how big the files are, when they were created, and the name of the file. Alright, so essentially what you're doing here is ls long, and then we are printing it in the previous directory in the hierarchy. Alright, so these are some stuff you can do with Spawn. Now, what if there are issues? Okay, there could be some issues. What if what you provide here is a directory that does not exist? Okay, let's see what happens. If you do that, nothing happens. Right? And obviously nothing's happening. Nothing is happening. There's something happening, actually. Okay, so what we are effectively calling is lspub. Okay, we're getting an error if we run this in the command line. So we should have gotten an error here. Well, the reason why we don't get it is because when errors occur, they're printed to the standard error stream. Okay, so what we need to do is listen for data events on that standard error stream of the child process. So let's do that. Okay, what we're gonna get is some error message. Okay, so let's go ahead and print that error. So now we expect print this error to the console, which is what we exactly get right here. Alright, so to be complete, let's go ahead and copy a file that we have in the directory. Let's copy that spawn.js file using a child process that we're going to call copy. So cp.spawn. I want to spawn a child process with the copy program. Okay, so let's provide some arguments. So which do you want to copy? I want to copy spawn.js. And then what I want to copy it into is, let's keep it simple, spawn1.js. Okay. and let's say I want to know when this process finishes. So I want to do copy that on, exit. So I'm just going to print that this process finished. So let's run this and see what we get. Okay, so it tells us that the copy process finished, and spawn.js is now copied into spawn1.js, and you can see they are exactly the same file. Alright, so what else we can do? We can create a directory in here, so let's go ahead and do that. There, so cp dot folder, I believe that's the name. Actually, cp dot spawn. Not thinking straight. Okay, so progs that folder. Okay, so what are the flags or arguments we need to provide here? We just need to provide the name of that folder that we're talking about. Now let's call this CSS. Could be. Alright, so let's go ahead and run that and see what we get. CSS, so here's our folder here. Alright, so these are the different things you can do using the spawn function. You can provide a command and have this spawn function create a new process for you. If you want to have access to the to whatever is printed to the standard out, you need to listen for the data event to that stream. Same goes for the standard error. If there are errors that are printed to that stream, you need to listen for the data event on it. One good thing that's important is whenever you're firing spawn, or whenever you're creating new processes, sometimes they may not be created, and you know, if they're not, you may not be able to know. So what's very important is that you always listen for errors on that child. So a good practice here would be to listen for the error event that gets emitted whenever an error occurs on that child process. And you know, these errors would usually occur when the child process could not be created. So an error event is emitted if that could not happen, if the spawn is not successful. The other time an error event could occur is if you could not kill, if a child process is running and the parent wants to kill that child process and could not. So you call to kill the child process and that didn't happen. So that's an error. An error will be fired. An error event will be emitted when such a thing occur. The other one is when a message is being sent from the child to the parent. And if that wasn't successful, you will also get an error event fired. All right, so let's go ahead here and just implement an error, you know, just listen for that error event. So let's do console.log error occurred. So I'm going to remove everything else here. I'm going to remove that copy, you know, that can be done. Remove that make there, you know, that can be done. What I'm going to do here is just keep a flag, just keep the L flag, but inside the options I'm gonna provide a bad directory. Okay, so now this directory doesn't exist when it goes to try and create the child process in this directory. It's not going to happen, and an error is going to occur. So it's going to tell us right here that an error occurred. Alright, so you always want to make sure you listen for that error event in case your child process could not be started. Alright, so this is the video, guys. We've learned how to create new child processes using the spawn function. And we've created child processes with commands that we are familiar with in Linux environments. We can provide some arguments like flags and, you know, other arguments to that command. And we can provide some additional options which could dictate which directory we want to create that that child process. What sort of environment variables are available to that child process, what sort of relationship that child process will have with its parents, and so on. Alright, so this is the video, guys. Please go ahead and subscribe if you want to see more of these videos. And, you know, I got plenty more videos coming about the child process module in Node.js. Go ahead and hit the like button if you like the videos, and I'll see you next time. Thanks, bye.